What's up, everybody? My name is Sebastian Bleak, and in this Astute Graphics tutorial, we're going to take a quick look at how to create a 3D tennis ball using some of the Astute Graphics plugins with a heavy focus on workflow. All right, so let's get started by creating a new document. This is just going to be a basic document, and whenever I have a new document open, I like to hide the artboards just to keep things nice and clean, and I want to bring up my grid. All right, now the shape that I need to create is a half circle. If I were to do this native in Adobe Illustrator, I'd probably draw a circle, then switch tools to the scissor tool and start clicking on anchor points so that I could get rid of portions of this shape. Now, instead of doing that, I'm gonna get some help from Subscribe, which is a free plugin by Astute Graphics. Over here towards the bottom left in the tools panel, here I have circle by two or three points. I'm going to click and hold. And the tool I want to go with is this one right here. It says arc, start, end direction. It's at the bottom of the stack. All right, now the way this tool works is you want to find your location. I'm going to use my grid here. Click once, and then move your cursor. All right, I'm going to go down 1, 2, 3, 4 squares. All right, if I hold down the shift key, it's going to keep that straight for me, and click. All right, as I move away, I have this Bezier handle that's creating my arc. I'll hold down the shift key to keep that handle nice and straight, and then find my location and click. All right, so now I have this perfect half circle here. Over here at the top left, I'm going to hide my stroke. And now I'm ready to convert this into a 3D shape. So over here at the top in the effect menu, I'm gonna scroll down to find 3D and then choose revolve. All right, in order to see this, you want to click on preview. That looks great. And I'll click OK. Now the color's not right. So over here on the top left, we're going to switch the fill color over to this yellowish green. And now it's starting to look like a tennis ball. The only thing missing is that stripe that we're used to seeing. So I'm going to create a symbol and wrap that symbol around this sphere. All right, back in the tools panel on the left, I'm gonna find this tool here. It's Dynamic Shapes, which is inside of Vector Scribe. Make sure you check out astutegraphics.com so you could find out more information about Vector Scribe. All right, with this tool activated, it's gonna bring up the Dynamic Shapes panel. I'm actually gonna tuck this guy away and just focus on the keyboard shortcuts. So again, using my grid, I'm gonna click and drag to draw out a new shape. Notice I'm drawing out a square. Before I release my mouse, if I hit the number 3 key, I could switch over to a different shape. Here I have the dynamic rectangle. All right, this looks like a good size. Now, I still want to round off these corners. I haven't released the mouse yet, so I'm going to hold down the Option key on a Mac, Alt on a PC, and then move my cursor towards the center of this shape. All right, once those little dots are on top of each other, I'm going to release, and that's going to create this awesome rectangle with these rounded corners. All right, I'm gonna get rid of this fill, and for the stroke color, I'm gonna go with a silver. Stroke weight, I'm gonna go with 10 points. All right, this looks great. Now I wanna convert this into a symbol. Over here at the top in the window menu, I'm gonna scroll through to find symbols. That's gonna bring up my symbols panel. Notice I have a lot of symbols in here. I could actually get rid of these by going into the flyout menu, choosing select all unused, and then throwing them away. But check this out, I also have a lot of swatches. I also have a couple of graphic styles in here. Now, a quick way to clear out all three is you come over here to the window menu, scroll through, and find Vector First Aid, another cool plugin by Astute Graphics. Click on that to bring up the panel. I'm gonna deselect my artwork and click on this button here. It says check document. When I click on that, it's gonna give me a list of some of the issues Vector First Aid found inside of this document. All right, so it's showing me here that I have 15 unused symbols, 53 unused swatches, and 6 unused graphic styles. All I have to do is click on fix all, and it's gonna clear them all out for me. All right, so let's bring back the symbols. And here we have a nice clean slate. All right, let's grab the shape, click and drag, bring it over here to the symbols. And I wanna name this symbol, tennis stripe. All right, click OK. Now that it's loaded into the symbols panel, I could get rid of the shape that's on my artboard. All right, I need to map that symbol onto my 3D object. I have it selected. I'll go into the appearance panel and then click 3D Revolve. That's going to bring up the effect that we recently applied. I'll click on preview so we can see our changes. And now let's go into this guy here. It says map art. When you click on that over here at the top, it shows us a symbol drop-down menu. In here, we just have our tennis stripe. So we only had one symbol in the symbols panel, so it makes it super easy to find the symbol that I need. I'll click on tennis stripe. Now it's just about resizing the symbol. I'm going to use the grid, click and drag. Come back over here, bottom left, click and drag. That looks good here on the grid, but if I look at my preview, it's a little large. I'll back off on the size slightly. Just making a couple of adjustments. Keeping an eye on my preview. I'll click OK. Now, one of the great things about working with 3D objects is you can always come back in here, reposition your artwork without having to redraw it all over again. All right, so I'm going to click OK. Zoom in slightly so you get a better look at that. And there you have it, folks. That's a quick look on how to create a 3D tennis ball using the Astute Graphics plugins. Make sure you head over to the Astute Graphics YouTube channel to find out more about their amazing products.